Hello everyone and welcome to Settlement and Survival. We're back here at Oberland Station to do the settlement tour because special thanks to Xosra for reminding me that I actually never finished this stupid thing. So I spent the last 3 or 4 days decorating and finishing up, adding furniture and junk and, you know, fiddling with stuff that I forgot or wanted to fix or whatever. So here is Oberland Station. In the Settlement and Survival universe here, this is going to be a small trade town designed to cater to ghouls who cannot get into Diamond City. It has an armor, and has an armor vendor over here, a weapons vendor. It doesn't have a doctor, but the Bunker Hill guy comes through here, so that's good enough. And it's that way if they get kicked out of Diamond City, they can come here and shop. So in the front here, you can see I've got the switching tower back there. In the front, we've got the armor vendor here, who's just kind of hanging out. And the weapon vendor's over here, who is a ghoul, of course, and she's got... Oh, hello, Pole. She's got that, and we'll go through the details later. This is going to be a weird one to tour because it kind of goes all over the place. The main entrance for the settlers is that red door, and there's a guard there watching it. I guess I should check these spots as I go in. Now, for the top here, I was going to make this a... I was going to make this the player house, but I figured this would be better served to be the provisioner's house because they don't ever sleep, so... This is where the provisioners stop and crash whenever they want to sleep. That's pretty much it. So a couple of cots that can rack out some random junk and a desk for keeping track of whatever the hell it is the provisioners need to keep track of. And there's our guard looking over the door. Of course, she's aligned with the Brotherhood of Steel, so I stole some of their armor. And two of the three guards are Brotherhood people. Now, the caravan post entrance is in here. Now, Oberlin, as we've noted before, is a tricky one to build on because it slopes off to the side really strangely. So I basically built this thing up on a top deck and shorted up underneath. But this is where the provisioners, the traders, come and hang out. They do use the chairs and they do maneuver through here pretty well because I have the dogs not Brahmin, so we don't get cow ass in our face every time we come in here. But this is kind of nice. It's easier for them to get in at, you know, through the door here. And we got another guard up here watching that approach and that other stuff. So we'll go over here. Ta-ta-da. Beacon's up there. It's off now. I got 9 people. That's enough. What are you doing over here?
How are you?
You're the guard. What are you doing? You're a prisoner? I don't know who you are.
Huh?
But one of the guards is here. And as you can see, he can see the approaches really, really well. Keep an eye on the tracks there. Block off the northern approach, and then the whole settlement, as you can see, well, not much of it back there. I don't know what you're doing over here. Are you a prisoner? No, you're not. Okay. So then we'll go back out the front here, or this side, and then go into the main settlement area. Now, there is one farmer. This is a self-supporting thing. They have enough food to feed everybody. But as, you know, you've seen before, I can shore up the workbench. I put the metal thing underneath there, snapped a bunch of crap to it. Got some under stair storage and some community storage there in the lockers. And then we've got a little rest area here with the shrubs growing up through it, because why not? From here, yeah, I guess we'll go up here. Two ways up. Always have two ways up so the settlers can pass through here pretty well. We have another guard here. This is the one looking over the gate. And, of course, their own. Here's their version of a nightlight. They can just put a candle in a pan and just carry it around, I guess. I don't know what they're doing. I don't know what they're doing. Got my bartender. Looking pretty good. Looking pretty stylish with his small, cozy little thing. So, of course, when people come in the entrance, they come straight up the stairs here, and they can do the bartender. Up top, we have their eating area. Kitchen supplies, a stove, everything's outside. Ignore that stuff. Ignore that tower in the background. You know, that's my my observation post to take my pretty screenshots with my thumbnail. Up here, the bartender sleeps there, and the armor vendor sleeps here. No, the weapon vendor sleeps here. But they've got their normal stuff. Nothing too outrageous here. Now, the back of the shop, she's got herself a counter and some snacks and some coffee and a bunch of ammo here.
That place is nothing but trouble.
And her supplies and guns, the display models here. A little bit of everything. She sells pretty much everything. Armor vendor with his display thing, and a provisioner stuck inside the thing. But yeah, the armor vendor sleeps here. This is his bed and his supplies and his quick fix table there, or whatever, what have you. Weapons workbench with the usual stuff. Little storage closet, I guess. The armor workbench with some supplies. Yeah, okay. Then come out this way, and we've got another turret watching the watching Beantown down there. Got another guard up here, and of course, you know, she's watching she's watching the approach as well. But yeah, the guards have really good sight lines here. It's really easy to make a fortified little area because of the way the elevation works. Got my lone farmer getting to work. She has a pair of outside bathrooms here. One of them's closed, one of them's open. With restroom stuff. Hi, Colonel Mustard. I got bathrooms in here. Now, in the back, the other way out is through here. This is where the couch is here. So they can come through this way. And we've got our power and a couple of... in a sawed-in-half train car that they kind of split in half and stuck in there. The first area is their relaxation area, I guess, where they can just sort of... well, we got a game of something going on here. Checkers, I guess. And then somewhere to sit and read books or whatever. This is pretty nice. Somewhere to get away from it all, so to speak, I guess. And then they have their... the guard... this is basically the barracks. The guards' beds are all back here, along with the farmer's beds in the back. So this is their mess hall, I guess? I don't know. Just a place where they can drink and eat and sit and whatever. So barracks number one, pair of beds in here with the normal stuff. A little bit of greenery there, and then the beds stacked here into two is here. So that's it. Just pretty heavy drug users in this group here. I guess they get bored. It's Oberland, you know. Oh, yeah, and the last thing, we have another restroom here with the usual accoutrement. So, that's the whole thing. It's, this is about, I don't know, maybe a size bar and a half. Because it's pretty dense. There's not a lot of stuff here, but it's pretty compressed, I suppose you could say. And let's do an outside tour so you can see the whole thing from the outside. See what visitors see when they go up here. But this, she's a provisioner. Okay, there's her dog. But that's the whole thing from the top of the north approach angle. And if you go outside, this is all walled off because I've been walling things off. I don't know, man. It's just the more I build, the more I'm inclined to wall off. But it's your normal scrappy, shored up, ragtag sort of cobbled together just crap. It's just, oh God. And then your guard is up here. So let's go back out this way and take a look at it from a distance. So that's what the braiders coming by will see. That's pretty ominous. That's kind of good, I think. In the back of it looks like this. And then the front, of course, looks like that. So that came out pretty good. So let's get up to our observation tower here and switch to nighttime. So you can see the limited lights, because this one here is definitely not bright at all. So here is the whole thing. Well, as much of it as can fit on the screen. So I'm going to switch to nighttime, do my little phase thing, and I will be right back. And here we are at night. It's the light is definitely focused on the main area over there on the right, but we'll go through here really quick and show you all what we've got here in terms of focus lighting and area lighting and the like. So the approach here looks like this. Gun shop is the brightest lit place, which would make a certain amount of sense here. Got another provisioner stuck in the back there. So we go up here, see if I can remember everything I did the first time. This is the provisioner's place. One thing I do like to do, though, when I have OCD, is I like to put candles on, like, the silver plates. Because it makes sense that they would have, to me, it makes sense they would have some sort of tabletop protection, I guess. I don't know. It makes sense in my head. Then we've got the trade vendor outpost, the caravan outpost. I like the way this one came out. Another trick I like to do is I like to use the fire pits and the concrete pillar to sink candles through the cinder blocks. Gives me a nice little lighting effect without having to put a bunch of bright lights everywhere. So, I don't know. Kind of neat. I think that's kind of neat. The guard doesn't have any light, of course, so we're not going to go there. Let's go down to the main entrance here with its side light. And we have a lot of bleed through from above, so this looks good underneath here, I think. And then this is the little rest area underneath. Then we've got, we go up to the top here. And here's this little candles in a pan nightlight. I think I'm going to use that again. That's kind of neat. I don't know. I like something about that. The bar, well lit, yes, with his yellow light, because he's fancy like that. He's still working. And their bedroom here. Nice and dark where they sleep, so they can sleep. Not a lot of light here. I guess they don't do a lot of night cooking. Go down here.
You know what I call a good day? One that ends without an empty
stomach.
We'll
go see her shop. So she's got her, you know, big stacks of ammo here on the deck. And then if she has to do any work at night on this thing or, you know, go through the drawer, she can see just fine. Not that they need to do that anyways, but I like to think that they use it that way. So, yeah. So this came out pretty good. I'm pretty happy with this whole build here. It's rustic, but it's sort of built up, and it's kind of good enough at everything, you know. It's not totally fancy. It's not gonna attract a lot of attention. It feels homey, you know, cozy, kind of lived in. And sticking that lantern on that tree branch is kind of fun. It was really easy. I didn't have any problem doing it. And their bedroom here, and then no, the bedroom's there. And that was the snack area, as it is. And there's their sleeping quarters. So that. Oh, let's go for the restroom here too. All candles in here. I didn't really use a lot of electric lights here. I didn't want to run conduits all over the place. It seemed to fit better to have candles and lanterns and, you know, sconces and the whatnots. So, well, I guess that's about it for this one. Hope you enjoyed the show. Hope this is interesting, give you some ideas for your builds. And if you want to see how this was built, of course, if you look back on the older streams, I pretty much did this entire thing, other than the trimming it up, live. So you can see how long this took. I think this is about a 25 hour build here. I don't know. Anyway, if you like what you see, I'd appreciate you hitting that like button. If you enjoyed what you saw here, I would appreciate it if you hit the like button. Let me know this is something that you would like to see more of. If you're new to the channel and you like this sort of thing, click subscribe and there will be more of this kind of thing. I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, everybody.